Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank you for our lives. We thank you for what you are set to do in the United States. We thank you for what you are set to do in Africa. We thank you for our leaders. We thank you for our ministries. We thank you for our business. Father, we thank you for everything. Ibrale cantono shuande lebele. Zelebrikenta la shatada bale. Rabat de bono shuande lebrehida bale sadabale. Radabade katoshe lebele. In zelebrikenta la shatada bale. Zelebrikenta la shatada bale da bosadaya. Anzale brokotoshe lebrehita la bale. In zelebrikenta la shatada bale. Zelebrikita la shatada bale. Zelebrikenta la shatada bale. Zelebrikenta la In Zelebrikenta Lasha Tanaba, Zalebrakenta Lasha Telebelida, Zalekata La Sunde Belida Bosa, Izule Brikinta Lasha Tanaba, Egara Dos Kento Lebrikita Labosi, Ezelebroconto Shelebrikita Labarat, Zalekata Lasha Catale Baraketa Layabala, Egra Dose Ketelibra Cantalasha Dabala, Embrikenta Lasha Tanabala, Zalebrakento Noshuan de Belida Bosa, Zelebrikenta Lasha Tanaba. Zalibra Kentalasha Telebelida Bosa, Embra de Katada, Embra Kentalaba, Embra Kentalaba, Embra Kentalaza, Embra Kentalaza, Azale Katosha Labalet, Ezele Kretos Katalaba Lekata, Azale Kotosha Le, Azale Kotosha Le, Azale Kotosha Le, Azale Kotosha Le, Azale Kotosha Lava Rakoto Zelebelida Bosa, Enzelu Rabodo Katosha Lebelida, Radia Badeketo Celebrehita Labala. In Brakento Dabere Ketelia Bosha Tadaba, in Brakenta Lassa de Belida Bosha, Zalibrakoto Celebrate de Bediano, in Brakenta Lasha Tadaba, in Zulu Brakenta Lasha Tadaba, in Zule Ketala Bade, in Zule Ketale Bada, in Zule Ketale Badat, in Zule Katele Badat, and Zalibrakos Kentelibo Shatadabala, in Brakoto Celebrate Lasha Tadaba, Embrakentala satole brehita rabale. Enzolo brekentala sadabale katoshele brehidaba. Enzule brekentala shadabale. Obada katala shatadabale katole brehidabosa. Izile kentozada. Izile kentozaba. Izile kentozaba. Zale katoshala. Enzolo katoshe ketele brehita rabale. Radia katala shakatadabada. Raja bada katada katada bada raja katala katada bade gata enzo lo brakenta la shada embro kenta le shata daba embra kento lo shakata daba embra kenta la shata 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 daba agarado badaya agarado sadaba agarato sadaba agarato sadaba agarato sadaba agarato sadaba agarato sadaba agarato sadaba egalakata gada Agataleso, Zelebrakota, Zelebrakenta, Zalevokoto Shadabale, Irabi Katada Katade Katade Katadadea, Ebraketeleso Dombelida, Ebrade Katoshele Berida, Ebrade Ketoshele Berida, Ebrade Ketole Teteliba, Ebrade Kotoshele Teliba, Rada Bade Katosha, Ebrekenta La Satanaba, Rada Bade Kata, Rade Bade Kata. Radicate de Bada, Jalakato Sadaba, Jalakato Sadaba, Aradakata, Zale Kotosha, Zele Brakenta. Igaraba Sutun de Belida Bosha, Radabade Ketele Sutun de Belida Bo, Imbrakenta La Sadabade Katanaba, Imbrakenta La Sode Belida Ba, Imperiadusha, Zalekatosha, Radakata Bada Katosha Nabale Katada Badeja, Rabada Katada Katosha Nevenida Bosa, Ezule Brekenta Losha Nabale, Abara Katozele Brekenta Lasso Tembelida Bosha Nabala, Rada Bade Katosha Nabrakenta Lassa Nevenida Ba, Igarato Zele Brekenta Lasso Devenida Ba, Inzolo Brekenta Lashata, Benesun de Benisha Nabala, Imbrakoto Zele Brekenta Nabala. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, we give you all the glory. Father, we give you all the honor. Father, we give you all the adoration. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
1 John chapter 5, verse 4. 1 John chapter 5, verse 4. He said, whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever that is born of God, I want to say it to Eclipse. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. That means for you to see earth bow, there must be heavenly, one must be heavenly born. Amen. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes. Let me tell you something. Everything that does not reflect God is of the devil. Stand up to it. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Everything that is not godly, that is at work in your body, in your soul, in your mind, are things that is supposed to stand up against. You are not supposed to be under them, they're supposed to be under you. Whatsoever is born of God. Let me tell you something. This is not a function of where you live. This is not a function of what is happening. This is a function of what you are yet to know or what you are yet to do. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. 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 Whatsoever is born of, I'm saying it for you to click, for you to know that Ephesians chapter 2, verse 5 and 6 is real. Oh my God, somebody's not here. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 5 and 6, they are real. Whatsoever is born of God, you are seated in heavenly places, far above, right hand of God with Christ Jesus.
Even when whatsoever, we were dead,
yes,
in trespasses,
yes,
made us alive together with Christ.
Yes.
By grace you have been saved, mm-hmm, and raised us up together and made us sit together
in heavenly places. You see that? Whatsoever is born of God, you don't compete with them because you are always ahead of them. Whatsoever is born of God, you know, understanding is the key to mentality. Whatsoever is born of God, whatsoever is born of God, whatsoever, I need it to click so you know that every situation you are going through right now is nothing compared to the purpose of God and plan concerning your life. Whatsoever is born of God, 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 overcomes the world. Not negotiate with the world, but what? It overcomes it. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. I don't know what else to say, but I will come to tell you today, until you come to your understanding of who you are, you will never lay on what belongs to you. Let me tell you something. You don't negotiate with anything that demeans you. You don't have a conversation with anything that does not give you peace of mind. When Jesus Christ gets into the temple, he does not negotiate with money changers. What did he do? He chased them away. Beat them and get out of the house shall be called the house of prayer. Whatsoever is born. And they have no capacity to fight Jesus. Why? Whatsoever is born of God overcomes. When he gets into the grave, when he gets into hell, the enemy does not have to struggle with him because they know his purpose. Whatsoever is born of God, he received all the power back because power has been given to me. Whatsoever is born of God, all power has been given to you to trample upon snake and scorpion over power of the enemy. Nothing shall my enemy hurt you. Whatsoever is born of God. I am giving you authority. Not I have given you to Facebook it. I have given you authority. Authority. Authority is what makes your enemy to come under your feet. I have not given you advice. Neither did I give you command. Neither did I give you order. I get authority means what other people cannot challenge. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. It does not manage the world, neither does it, you know, relate the world. Rather, he does what? He overcomes it. Lord, I am of God. Let everything that is making me live with those human beings disappear from my arena.
Amen.
Lord, I am of you. Stand up on your feet, everybody. Whatsoever is born of God, whatsoever is born of God, open your mouth and pray. Whatsoever is born of God, let that keep. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever, if you don't know it, you will doubt it. If you don't know it, you will doubt it. Whatsoever is born of God, whatsoever is born of God. Lebra kentala shatana bale, ezule breketa nejana bale kato shelebre hitana bala, raba babale kato nebala kabala katara bala, labra kentala sode brade kato nebala, rada bale kato sebra kentala kato shkete nebeli daba, ezelo kuntu shelebre kete nebala shatana bale, ezelo breketa nejana bala, raba dekata dekato shadaba deketeria. I wish you can pray some more. I wish you can put more energy into it in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. 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 Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Sickness. I am born of God. I overcome you. Lord, pain. I am born of God. I overcome you. The borrowing. I am born of God. I overcome you. Failure. I am born of God. I overcome you. Whatever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatever is born of God overcomes the world. Zale brakintale shote belida. He said, Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. This is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever is born of God overcome. Let's continue reading. He said, this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. What overcomes the world? Faith. 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 Faith in God. Hebrews 11 says, without faith it is impossible to please God. Whosoever that comes to God must know that he is a real God and He is a rewarder of those that diligently. So you must seek God diligently to have a faith. And if you are not a faith person, you can never be an overcomer. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. Let's continue reading. Verse 5 said, who is he that overcomes the world? But he that believeth that Jesus what is the Son of God. We want to pray right now using the name of Jesus. Lord, by your name, every intention of the kingdom of darkness in my life come to nothing.
Amen.
Every plan and purpose of hell is canceled.
Amen.
Every evil agenda is interrupted.
Amen.
Every standing purpose lose their stand.
Amen.
Every agreement of evil over my life will never come to pass.
Amen.
Isaiah 54 verse 14, please. Surely they will gather the word of God said. Surely they will gather the word of God said. But not by me. Whosoever gather against you shall fall for your sake. Every gargum of hell against God's plan and purpose will frustrate their plan right now in the mighty name of Jesus.
In righteousness.
In righteousness.
You shall be established.
You shall be established and you shall be far from oppression. Yes.
For you shall not fear.
You shall not fear.
And from terror.
From terror.
For you shall not come near you.
It shall not come near you.
Indeed, they have surely assembled.
Did you see that? That's verse 15.
But not
because. Surely they will. No. They are ganged up, but God does not say we not stop here to gang up. But the Bible said, if they gang up, they will scatter. If they gang up, let me tell you something. Anything that does not look like God in your life is devil. It's simple. Don't even think that I'm in U.S., I don't have papers, I'm in U.S., I'm not married, I'm in U.S. Don't you know people are barren in Nigeria? The same way they are barren here. People are single in Nigeria, the way they are single here. People are born in Nigeria. So it's not about where you are, it's about who you are. Because anointing does not leave behind. It goes with you. You don't remove anointing. You say, hey, okay, Rotimi, I'm going to take off my suit now. No! Anointing does what? It stays with you. Amen. I don't know why I removed my suit. Praise the Lord. Somebody say, what are you doing? Exactly what I'm doing. You cannot remove anointing. Anointing goes with you. That's why when you are sleeping, it's upon you. Amen. What am I talking about this morning? Anointing, you have to carry God. Somebody shout hallelujah. He said, in righteousness shall you be established, but it shall be far from oppression. He said, surely they will gather. But whosoever gathers against you, they shall fall. Lord, we pray by the power in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let every evil gang up fall.
Amen.
Let every evil gang up fall.
Amen.
Let every evil gang up fall.
Amen.
Let every evil gang up fall. The tower of Babel refused to be built. Because God came down and scattered it. In the name of Jesus, every evil gang up fall right now. Over your life, over your destiny, over your family, over your ministry. Every evil gang up begin to fall. They begin to fall. They begin to fall. They begin to fall. Evil gang up, fall. Evil gang up, fall. Evil gang up, fall. In the name of Jesus, wherever you are, they gather. That they want, they don't want you to laugh. Wherever that they gather, they don't want you to share testimony. Wherever they gather, that they don't want you to go far. Wherever that they gather, they don't want to have impact. Oh, Lord of heaven, they must fall. They must fall. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Anyone that stand up against your finances, anyone that stand up against your career, anyone that stand up against your family, anyone that stand up against your children, anyone that stand up against your future, anyone that stand against your immigration status, we declare by the power in the name of Jesus. They must fall. They must fall. They must fall. They must fall. The word of Jericho fell down flat. The word of Jericho fell down flat. Goliath fell down flat in the name of Jesus. Jezebel was disappointed. Haman was disappointed. Oh Lord of heaven, wherever they gather, I'm not saying that they should not gather, but I'm saying that they must fall. I'm saying that they must scatter. Anyone that gang up against your children, those who gang up against your husband, those who gang up against your wife, those who gang up against your promotion, against your movement, against your progress, by the word of the Lord, we stand here with the decrees. They must fall. 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 Every disappointment in your life, whosoever instigating it, those who instigate it, those who plan it, those who surmount it, they must fall. They must fall. They must fall. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
God that did not spare Goliath will never spare your enemy. Oh, nobody say amen.
Amen.
You know what I said? I mean, God did not spare him. Do you know the meaning of spare? To protect somebody, to shield somebody, to guide something away from him. So he wasn't spared, despite all his height. Let me tell you something, it's not by height, it's by spirit of the Lord. Because God will never disappoint his own children. I said, David, you will take the palace.
Amen.
Oh, nobody say amen.
Amen.
Are we praying today?
Yes, sir.
I said, David, you will take your palace.
Amen.
As a Daniel, you will take your place.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
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 Amen.
Oh Lord, disappoint my enemy.
Amen.
Oh Lord, disappoint my enemy.
Amen.
Frustrate their plan.
Amen.
Thwart their intention.
Amen.
Cut off their source.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Pray that prayer. Pray that prayer.
Thwart their plan.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh Lord,
for in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, frustrate the plan of the enemy. Cut off their source. Dismantle their plan. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Please pray this prayer. What does it? Please pray this prayer. Maybe we should read it. Matthew, is it chapter 13? From verse 25. Olorun ki ma nse bi. Do you know the meaning? God do not do evil.
But while men slept.
But why men slept?
His enemy came and sowed tares.
And sowed tares
among the wheat and went.
Among the wheat and went his way. You see that the enemy will never wait to sympathize with you. They will never wait to empathize with you. They will never wait to have compassion on you. They will not sympathize. They will not empathize. They will not have compassion. God don't do evil, man. Psalm 118, verse 1. We're going to come back to Matthew 13. But let's read that Psalm 118. He said, oh, the Lord is good and his mercy endures forever. God is a merciful God. His compassion fails not. Lamentation chapter 3.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord.
Yes,
for he is good, for his mercy endures forever.
His mercy endures forever. Anything you are going through that does not look good is not God. Let that sink. God will never take your wife from you. God will never take your husband from you. God will never allow them to fire you. God will never make you to be in US for 10 years, 20 years, and you don't have your paper. No, God does not do evil. Anything that you see that is not good is not God. That is why Job said, declare a thing, and the word shall be established. Amen.
Amen.
Let's continue. Matthew 13. Let's continue with that. From verse 25. But why men slept? But why men slept? If I tell you the virtue, evil virtue, that the enemy has placed inside sleep, you will not sleep again. Somebody say, you mean that you don't sleep again? Sleep is good. Sleep is good. But you will never know what the danger that is going on during sleep time. Ma, do you know that story? In, sorry, I think it's 1 Kings chapter 3. Please don't close Matthew 13. Let me take you something. I will show you something now. Amen. Amen.
Verse 1.
Nope. From verse 16.
Now, two men.
Two men.
Who were harlots.
Yes.
Came to the king.
Yes.
And stood before him.
And stood before him.
And one woman said.
One woman said.
Oh my lord.
Oh my lord.
This woman and I.
Yes.
Dwell in the same house.
We dwell in the same place.
And I gave birth while she was in the house.
Yes.
And I then it happened.
It happened.
The third day.
The third day.
After I gave him birth.
After me.
That this woman
yes.
also gave birth.
She gave birth also.
And we were together.
And we were together.
No one was with us.
Yes.
In the house.
No one was with
except
us.
Except for the 12.
God leave you with the enemy. No one was with you. God leave you with the devil. You don't know. But when a woman, powerful one of God died, I said, God, what happened? God said, I have make everything available. But what you don't have activate will never be used for you. There's an activation for protection. Activation for provision, activation for good health. Ah, I pray in the name of Jesus, everything that needs activation in your life, they are activated right now.
Amen.
God said, if you don't activate protection, forget it, it's never been used for you. Enemy will even use against you. Say, that woman and I were in the house. No one. We're going to go back to that Matthew. When God, they came to God, he said, God, can we go and remove this wheat from the other something? God said, no, let them grow together. The most dangerous statement in the Bible that I've never read. God said, leave the good and what? And the evil to go together. Ah! So this is something. If good and evil live together, because good is what? Quiet. What happened to evil? Subdue it. That was why we have evil on every street. Because what you, that's why when you are on this table right now and somebody is down, the person down has more power to what? To pull you down. Then you need more power to pull the person up. That's why I said this. If you cannot convert the enemy, your unbeliever, retain your salvation. If you cannot remove somebody from poverty, retain your prosperity. If you cannot help people out of sickness, retain your healing. It is you first, though. Don't forget that. Forget what anybody say. Some people are destined to be where they are. Leave them. Jesus had to be the Son of God first before he can help us. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let's continue reading. 1 Kings chapter 3, please. No stranger with us.
And it happened.
Yeah, and it happened.
The third day.
Let me tell you something. Anytime you are with the devil and you do nothing, it's something will happen. And in your, you are with the devil, you don't pray. Devil is planning for you. You have a marriage, you don't pray. A plan has been set for you. No one was with us. Let me tell you something. Because you don't see no one does not mean no one was with you. The enemy was with you. Help me. Let's read. Because of time. He said, this woman's child died in the night because she overlaid on it. Do you see that?
So she arose in the middle of the night.
Yes.
And took my son from
her. He took my son.
While your maid servant slept.
Yes.
And laid him in her bosom.
Yes.
And laid her dead child.
Do you know what happened when you are asleep? Yeah. When you are asleep, what happened?
The enemy does evil.
Not evil. The chin, the swap. If it's evil, it's good. They think you think you are still okay, not knowing that they have changed what belongs to you. Ah! I will not receive fake instead of original.
Amen.
Oh, nobody say amen.
Amen.
I mean, I refuse to receive a fake instead of original.
Amen.
See why they slept? Because you are asleep, what happened? The woman tiptoe and switch. Your destiny will never be switched for nothing.
Amen.
Let's go back to that Matthew, please.
But when the grain had sprouted,
yes,
and produced a crop,
yes,
and the tares also appeared.
Uh-huh.
So the servants of the owner.
Why? Let's go back a verse before that.
But while men slept,
his enemy came.
And sowed tears
among the wheat.
He went his way. But when the grain had sprouted,
so the woman took the baby, switched the baby, and went away. Enemy does not care the consequences of where you face. They just want their own pleasure. So they can, let me tell you something. Anyone who does not have a future, you will never care to scatter your own. I want everybody here, please. Anyone who doesn't have a future, will never care. They just want to create more chaos and they will drag more people to themselves. I want everybody, please. Praise the Lord. Why men slept, the enemy came to sow tears. Why men slept, the enemy came to sow tears. The width and the tears. Continue reading.
And produced a crop.
Yes.
Then the wheat and the tares,
yes,
also appeared.
Two of them were growing together because they are left together. Go ahead.
So the servants of the owner came.
What did he say?
And said to him.
And said to him,
sir.
Sir.
Do you not sow good seed in your field?
Yes.
How then does it have tares?
Yes.
So he said to them.
What did he say?
The enemy has done this.
The enemy has done this. Go ahead. Go ahead.
The servant said to him.
What verse are you now?
28.
Go ahead.
Then the servant said to him.
He said to him.
Do you want us then to go and gather them up?
He said, do you want us to scatter it and just... No. What did he say?
Do you want us to go and gather them up?
Yes.
But he said...
He said...
No.
No.
Let's try to gather up the tares.
The tares.
And you also uproot the wheat.
Yes.
Let both grow together.
Let both grow together.
Until the harvest.
Lord, give me the capacity to withstand the enemy.
Amen.
To overpower them. Because we live in a world where good and evil grows together. That's why you will do nothing at work for somebody's hate you.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need to do anything. For you to be on point, you are somebody's hatred.
Mm-hmm.
For you to be hardworking.
Mm-hmm.
For you to believe in Jesus. You don't call them to come to church.
Mm-hmm.
That you say you are your Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Why? That is the enemy.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus life. That is the whip and the tears parable. See, leave them and them grow together. That is a woman with a good son or a good child. That was switched. You don't want to know the danger of not being a child of God. You don't want to know the danger of not knowing God. You don't want to know the danger of not praying. Let me tell you something. Your immigration paper, what you are struggling with in your head, it's a function of the enemy has done this. When men slept. Lord, wake me up. I'm tired of sleeping a dangerous and a costly sleep. The sleep that, you know, the sleep that might disturb your destiny, the sleep that might create unrest for you, you will not sleep such a sleep.
Amen!
Stand up on your feet and pray. Lord, no matter the evil around me, I will never fall for evil.
Amen.
I will never let God my die for evil. No matter the evil, no matter the evil, no matter the evil, No matter the evil. In the name of Jesus, the Lord of God, the word of God will stand in my life. In the name of Jesus, La Rabasha Katadabala, Radabada Katadabade, Radabade Katadabade, Radabade Katadabade. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Write this down. Anytime you leave the stage for Goliath, you will lose your head. Goliath did not come with an intention to play with you. It comes with intention to take your territory. Until the David inside of him step out, he will continue to run more than 40 days. And as a David asks of you, inside of you, know that you are on a mission to bring the head of Goliath down. If you are not on a mission, you will never be commissioned. God does not do evil. Anything that you see an enemy has done this when men slept. At when you are not a prayerful person, you are a victim of circumstances. They will steal your head, they will steal your finances, they will steal your joy, they will steal your marriage, they will steal everything. One of the things that's been complained about is that the West, the Europe, the everybody, they've gone to America, Africa, to take the best of Africa. And now they are preventing them to come to America and Europe. Can you imagine? They steal the gold, steal the this, steal the that. But that's one of the things that people are agitating about. When you don't have a defense, you will lose your head. And anytime you have a dependent, you need a defender. Life is just like that. Anytime you work, you have a people depend on you, then you need what? A defender. Because the weight of the people that have joined themselves with you will not help you to move. But with a defender, they will help you up to move. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Maybe we should read about that David. Let's see what's there. First Samuel chapter 17, please. Let's start from here. If somebody asks you, why are you doing what you are doing? Tell them there is a cause. Do you know what it means? I'm not doing this because I want to do it, but there is a cause. There is a battle to fight. There is a winning that belongs to me. First Samuel chapter 17, verse 29. There is a cost. There is a cost, sorry.
David said,
yes.
What have I done now?
What have I done?
Is there no cost?
There is a cost.
When it turned from him.
There is a cost. Somebody said there is a cost.
There is a cost.
This prayer is because there is a cost. Something has happened. Something has happened. Why are you praying right now? There is a cause. One day I'm going to preach that message. Very powerful. If you are sleeping, because there is no cause. And let me tell you something. When you wake up, you find a cause. Those who sleep, when they wake up into a cause. Why are you awake? There is a cause. Why are you praying? There is a cause. There is a cause to make your children to be 10 times better than you. There is a cause for everything fighting you in your family. And you are abroad right now, the same thing is still fighting you. There is a cause. There is a cause because your health must be sound as God has designed for you. There is a cause because you must not live like your father, married to five wives. There is a cause. There is a cause. There is a cause. Don't ever cross your leg thinking there is no cause. There is a cause. And the fight that you don't fight today, you are successfully postponing for somebody else to fight. So today is the right time. Because what? There is a cause. There is a cause. Somebody who knows me very well said to me, you have taken over from your mommy. I said, no. I said, I start my own. My mother happened to be a prayer warrior. She prayed. But I never go to her say, mommy, okay, and then pray for me. No! If you are waiting for somebody to pray for you, you know, some people even you are already falling in Nigeria. He said, Pastor, can you fast for me? Can you imagine somebody buy a gas?
Sure.
Somebody buy a gas in your car and they expect their own car to drive. Is it possible?
No, sir.
You have to understand it. Your wife cannot eat for you. Your father, your mother cannot eat for you. The most dangerous thing is that the anointing of Elijah will never be effective on Elijah until Elijah did what he's supposed to do.
Mm-hmm.
Regardless of the double portion. You know, there is a law of activation that if you don't bring it up, it will never succeed. But it's dead. Do you know the the adventure that got into it for them to discover crude oil. Do you know why people don't sleep? You are using Facebook. Do you know some people don't sleep to keep Facebook up? You are using Google. Do you know some people don't sleep to keep Google up? Let me tell you, anytime you don't stand up to keep something up, when you wake up, it's dead. There is a cost. There is a cost to keep your marriage. No, this thing is not fake. This thing is real. There is a cost. Cost. Whatever you call it, it's C-A-U-S-E. You read your Bible, it's dead. You know, when I'm... Can you stop, baby? There is a cost, not a cost. A cost. Type it there for them. Amen. C-A-U-S-E. There is a cost. 1 Samuel chapter 17. Chapter 17, verse 29. There is a cost. If you don't meet your cost and just do what you're supposed to do, you will see that yet the wheat will take over the garden. Somebody say, God forbid. Somebody say, God forbid. Somebody say, God forbid. You must stand up and take responsibility because there's a what? There is a cost. Not a cost. A cost. There's even a cost. Okay, let me put it right. For you to win your cause, there is a cost. What about that? Is that better? Amen. Somebody shout hallelujah. So what happened? Let's look at the battle. Verse 33, because of time, please. 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 33.
And Saul said to David,
is that David?
You are not able to go against this Philistine.
Listen, did you see that?
To fight with him.
Did you hear that? No, what that means?
Yes.
You step out to start a business. Say, hey! Nobody ever start a business in our family. It will never work. You are ready to get married. Nobody. Let me tell you something. One of the things that I did when I gave my life to Christ, I turned completely even from my family in Nigeria. If you don't know, if I tell you where I started from, you will not believe. Somebody said, hey, Rotimi, you know. I said, I don't know anything here. I am gone. I'm an astronaut. I am gone. If you don't follow another course, another lane, you will end up in the same destination like them.
God forbid.
Follow. I call it the law of opposite direction. Nobody's writing anything now. Can you imagine that? If you don't go in the opposite direction of the people that you want to help, what happened? Nothing will happen. Do it in a different way. Pray differently. Fast differently. Live a life differently. Until you go in the opposite direction, your life will never have meaning, impact. If you are eating 3 times a day, you eat 1 time a day. Opposite direction. Change your church. Start serving God. Read your Bible, fast and pray. Because what happened? There is a cause. And for you to take ownership of your cause, there is a cost. And for you to pay that cost, you must be commissioned. Maybe we should put in like 3 C's. I need to write down the 3 C's of life. A cost, a cost, and a commission. I'm going to write on it. Watch out. Somebody shout out the beer. You know, we're going to be back here by the grace of God, by 6. We're going to continue. There is a cost. There is a cost. There is a cost. Saul said to David, you cannot go out and take ownership of this life. Let me tell you something. In the realm of the spirit, you remember that David has been anointed. Right? Anytime you have received anything divinely, then you should be ready to face earthly persecution. People that you expect to support you, they will reject you. It's not them, it's the devil. An enemy has done this when men slept. That's why we're going to end today. Lift up your right hand and begin to worship the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you. We'll be back in the next 2 hours to blast in tongues and the take ownership of our life. Don't forget, for in life there is a cost. For you to maximize your cost, there is a cost. And for you to take ownership, for you to pay the cost, you must do what? Commission. Lift your right hand, worship the name of the Lord. Say, God, we thank you. Lord, we give you all the glory. Lord, we give you all the honor. Lord, we give you all the adoration. There is no one like you, Lord. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
My mother told me, if you have ever watched that video on Facebook, on YouTube, or anywhere, after this, go and search for it. Seven life lessons that I learned from my mother. And the first thing he said, if your children does not have peace, never go to bed. You know, we see this on parents now, they will just cross their leg. I learned it from my dad. When everybody has gone, he will look around the house and bring it down to the realm of the spirit. You are watching your children living a life and you think everything will be okay. No, life gets deteriorated when nobody integrates back to where it's supposed to be. Life gets what? Life, the smoke dies. If something is going down the hill and you don't take your initiative to set a barrier, what happens? It will go into the ditch. It is time there is a cause. It is time there is a cause. I pray in the name of Jesus, you will not cry.
Amen.
Oh, nobody said that. I pray that everything that has been marked from the kingdom of hell, every next death that has put concerning you, every frustration in business, every happiness that has been stolen, every secret that has been deployed, every frustration that has been planned by the power in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I change every evil cause against you right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because there is a cause and you have come into the battlefield of life to take responsibility, the power to pay the cost, receive it.
Amen.
And as you are ready for the cost, David was commissioned. When he hear the word anointing, and he was commissioned to be enthroned. I pray for the anointing to be commissioned. Receive in the name of
Amen.
Jesus. You will pay the price.
Amen.
You will win your cause.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I will say, surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. It is my turn to shine.
It's
my year of life. By the empowerment of the Holy Spirit, we will rise and shine. Give somebody a night pastor, there is a cause, and I will pay the price because I'm commissioned by God.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.